This
Can you
conference
hear
will
me
now be recorded.
Yes, sir. You are audible, sir. Okay, good. हाँ सर, आपकी आवाज आ रही है सर. आपका स्वागत है सर.
थैंक यू वेरी मच.
हेलो, सुन पा रहे हैं?
जी सर,
हाँ सर,
मुझे जी
नमस्कार.
सर.
आपकी आज्ञा से हम कार्यक्रम का प्रारंभ करें.
या प्लीज प्लीज.
जी 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 आज का हम कार्यक्रम प्रारंभ करते हैं. वी स्टार्ट टुडेज प्रोग्राम विच इज ऑन Vedic informatics, and I am so very happy that today this session is to be chaired by none other than our very very prominent and a luminary MLA of Vikasnagar, Sri Munna Singh Chauhan ji. And as I had told you before, not only he is an intellectual, he is a scientist, but at the same time he has a keen interest in all these traditions and Vedic systems. And when I requested him to be part of this webinar, so not only he readily agreed to this whole idea, but there he will be with us during the course of this webinar, and he will also enlighten us with his very 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 luminary words of wisdom. So we welcome you, sir. And today this webinar, this has been organized primarily by Dev Sanskriti University, Shanti Kunj, Haridwar. And as we know, Shanti Kunj has been the primary center, seat of learning, especially when it comes to Vedic science, Vedic literature, Vedic traditions. So Professor Abhay Saxena from Dev Sanskriti University, who is professor, head and dean, Professor Abhay Saxena, I welcome you, because not only he envisaged and he is closely working with you, sir. Or Professor Abhay Saxena ka idea tha ki during this, amid this lockdown, and especially when this pandemic COVID-19, it has engulfed the whole planet, so there this Vedic informatics would be much too fruitful, and it will provide a new way forward. So this is Professor Abhay Saxena. We welcome you on behalf of USAC, because he will take it forward this webinar. So, and with us many professors, and especially from world over, we have Professor Anish Kumar Mehra from South Africa. He's a very senior eminent professor. We welcome you, sir. We have Mr. John Ram, and he's joining us from Sydney. We welcome you, Professor Narayanan, and he's a very senior professor from Malaysia, from Mrs. Pragya Govind, and from again from United Kingdom. And we have Mayank Rathor, and he's joining us from Dubai. Sri Uma Sankar Pandey joining us, and he's a very senior software engineer from New Jersey. He's joining us. And we have Ankit Patel. He is joining us from Kazakhstan. We have Vinita Vadra, Again, he is from Maharashtra. We have Shivnarayan Prasad, again from Dev Sanskriti University. In fact, Dev Sanskriti University, they have composed an entire music, you know, this small capsule. So there they would be with us. And we have Professor Sanjay Sharma, we have Professor Hiren Joshi from Gujarat, very senior professor, Professor M.P. Thapliyal, very senior professor from HNB Garhwal University. We have a host of eminent personalities who are there with us, part of this webinar. We have Dr. Hardik Joshi, again from Gujarat University. We have Vibha Kashyap, again director, and Belgaum, Bangalore, she is from Lucknow, Nisha Jain from Rishikesh, and Tarun Srimali, Director Research Development, and he is from Rajasthan, Vikas Visaria. Hello,
sir, we can hear.
And we have Vikas Visaria, Hiren Joshi, and we have so many students, and from Roorkee also, Mohammed Wasim Fateh, and we have this entire team from USAC, scientists, from Dr. O.P. Nautiyal, to host of people, they are there. So I welcome them all, and now because I'll be speaking about this webinar, but before that, I'll request Professor Abhay Saxena to take it forward. I once again welcome Sri Munna Singh Chauhanji for his time, and despite, you know, all odds.
We are welcoming with e-book also, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Durgesh Pansa. So, and we must we welcome all the dignitaries across the globe, especially Maniya Shri Munna Singh Chauhan sir, aapka hardik swagat hai. Aur isi kram ko aage badhate hue main request karunga Professor Shivnarayan Prasad ji se, jo ki hum sab ke beech mein hain. Aap sangeetajna hain, aapki PhD sangeet mein hai, aajkal Dev Sanskriti Vishwavidyalaya mein sahacharya ke pad par hain. मैं उनसे आग्रह करूंगा कि वो गायत्री मंत्र और वैदिक ऋचाओं से इस कार्यक्रम की शुरुआत करने का कष्ट करें. डॉक्टर शिवनारायण प्रसाद जी
नमस्कार. कल्याणकारी भावों के साथ वैदिक मंगलमय मंत्रों के साथ लोग ये कार्य शुरू कर रहे हैं. तत्सवितुर्वरेण्यं भर्गो दिवस्य धीमहि यो नः प्रचोदयात्. ॐ गणानां पादनपति को भवामहे. प्रियपतित्वं हवामहे. नाम त्वां पतित्वं हवामहे. वशो मङ्गाहं जानि गर्भदमा त्वं जासि गर्भदम्. ॐ स्वस्ति न इन्द्रो विधस्रवा, स्वस्ति नः पूषा विश्ववेदाः, स्वस्ति नस्तारक्षो वरिष्ठनी, स्वस्ति नो बृहस्पतिर्दधातु. ॐ वयः पृथिव्यां वयोषधीषु, वयो दिव्यन्तरिक्षे वयोधा, वयस्वतीः प्रदिशः शन्तु मह्यं वा. ॐ विष्णो रराट वशी विष्णो, स्नपृष्ठो विष्णो शूरसि विष्णो असि वैष्णवसि विष्णवे त्वा ॐ अग्निर्देवतावातो देवता सूर्यो देवता चंद्रमा देवता वसवो देवता रुद्रा देवता आदित्या देवता मरुतो देवता विश्वे देवा देवता बृहस्पतिर्देवतेन्द्रो देवता वरुणो देवता ॐ विश्वानि देव सवितर्दुरितानि पराशुव यद्भद्रं तन्मयाशुव ॐ शान्तिः शान्तिः
प्रोफेसर सक्सेना आगे बढ़ाइए।
मंगलमय गीत के पश्चात मैं निवेदन करना चाहूंगा इस कार्यक्रम के सूत्रधार माननीय डायरेक्टर महोदय प्रोफेसर दुर्गेश पंत जी से, जो कि सर की विभिन्न विचारधाराओं को हम सबके बीच में समय समय पर प्रस्तुत करते रहे हैं, जिन्होंने वैदिक इन्फॉर्मेटिक के कंसेप्ट पे हम सबको कई बार मार्गदर्शन दिया है। मैं प्रोफेसर दुर्गेश पंत जी से विनम्र निवेदन करता हूँ कि समस्त माननीयों के स्वागत भाषण हेतु हम सभी को संबोधित करने का कष्ट करें। माननीय प्रोफेसर दुर्गेश पंत जी।
मैं पहले भी मैंने जैसा कहा, मैं माननीय मुन्ना सिंह चौहान जी का बहुत स्वागत करता हूँ। अपने जितने हमारे प्रोफेसर्स हैं फ्रॉम ऑल अराउंड द वर्ल्ड, फ्रॉम ऑल अराउंड द ग्लोब, आई वेलकम देम, आई वेलकम ऑल द प्रोफेसर्स एंड ऑल एकेडमिशियन एजुकेशनिस्ट एंड एवरीवन दोज हु आर पार्ट ऑफ दिस वेबिनार एंड ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट। सी आई विल बी वेरी ब्रीफ। व्हाट वी हैव सीन इज, यू नो, दिस एंटायर यूनिवर्स एज वी से दिस वाज क्रिएटेड अबाउट अप्रॉक्सिमेटली 13.5 billion years back, as we say this Big Bang, and we in computer science we say Big Bang at times, because Big Bang happened that created the universe, but Big Bang is when we say the informatics started flowing. The Earth was created, as we know, this 4.5 billion years again, 4.5 billion years back approximately. But the modern man, we, the Homo sapiens, the wise man, we appeared some 200,000 years back, 2 lakh saal pehle, and part of this cosmic calendar as we stand today on this 28th of April, today is and 2020. So
आप दिखाई नहीं दे रहे ना,
आवाज नहीं आ रही है सर।
उसको दिखाई दे रहे
ये जो फ्रेंड से बात
है ये लग रहा है सर उनका नेट वगैरह चला गया नाइट टू जाना से नहीं इसी के अंदर उसमें वो होता वो इन्वर्टर में
कुंद जोशी जी क्या आवाज आ रही है सर प्रोफेसर नौटियाल सर आवाज आ रही
जी सर मुझे
आवाज आ रही है सर आपकी आवाज आ रही है
लग रहा है कि प्रोफेसर पंत सर का कुछ सिस्टम तक ऑन होता है तब तक हम लोग
इन्फॉर्मेटिक्स informatics means takes into account hello
sir
am I audible
yes sir
yeah
hello
yes
sir. Am I audible
yes sir
yes, so
sir.
Informatics yeah, when we say informatics when we say informatics we do mean to say yes you know this epitome of technology this machine learning to AI to all those things that this modern science and technologies have achieved and other hand we have Vedic you know sciences Eastern philosophy so can we talk in terms of some blending between these two so that it could help humanity in general and it could be a new way of looking at things because we talk about Bodhisattva at USARC we have a Bodhisattva program we talk about middle path as to best of everything that we can put together so along these lines because Dr. Saxena yesterday only we were discussing about it very short time period not only could he organize so this is the whole crux how we take it forward and because I would also request Sri Chauhan Saab Munna Singh Chauhan ji that he would also you know he will also provide his very insightful thoughts the professors from all around the world and Professor Saxena will give a detailed presentation as to how we can take it forward it is kind of going to be a keynote address and then we have Swapnil has a wonderful presentation he is an amazing person researcher and he has given a way forward he talks about from Harvard to Haridwar and from Harvard to Hindustan to Uttarakhand so can we have this new knowledge coming up because ultimately this new knowledge creation it is going to help this humanity at large because ultimately if humanity survives so everybody survives and this is the whole crux of Bodhisattva so I welcome you once again all professors everyone we will because it's a webinar so we will have an interaction session also after all these thoughts so thank you Professor Saxena so now kindly take it forward maybe we can request Sri Munna Singh Chauhan ji for his initial thoughts on Vedic informatics
thank you Professor Dubey and good afternoon to everyone those present in this wonderful webinar on the Vedic informatics me for this is going to be a learning experience as we know from the ancients that Vedas Vedic knowledge is a basics to everything, basics to all sort of knowledge. And my personal handicap is I don't have a knowledge of Sanskrit, and understanding a Vedic literature or the Vedic science or the Vedic knowledge without Sanskrit is something like impossible. But whatever little I could learn from the translations that are available in the different domain, as a student of the science and as a, you know, the practicing politician, and having worked with the very prestigious organization of the Government of India, that is DRDO, Defense Research and Development Organization. So it's something like Jack of all trade and master of none. I'll only be sharing some, you know, the kind of a peripheral and, you know, like the top layer of the knowledge without going into the depth of it all. You know, the irony is that the Vedic knowledge, we did not ever try to build on the Vedic knowledge. If we put aside Professor Max Muller, who have done such a wonderful work on the Vedic literature and the Sanskrit and the establishing a link between the Vedic knowledge and the literature and the modern science and the, you know, the medical science and so many things. So frankly, much was not contributed in this field. I'm very happy that Dev Sanskrit Vishwavidyalaya has picked up the subject, and Dev Sanskrit Vidyalaya has a tremendous contribution in studying the Vedic sciences. And that way, I take pride in welcoming you all to this webinar, in the sense that this university is established. This university is in Uttarakhand, and I, being a legislator of the state, I welcome you all to this program. This part of the land we call Uttarakhand is situated in the Middle Himalaya. And the Himalaya, as we know from the time immemorial, is considered to be a, you know, like home to like Ayurveda, home to Vedic knowledge, home to so many spiritual knowledge. That way, if we, as I said in the beginning, as a working politician, or as a part of the system of the governance, or as someone who is responsible to some extent in drafting the government policies, then I'd like to point out that our ancient knowledge, the Vedic knowledge, the Vedic astrology, the Vedic astronomy, the Vedic medicine, the Ayurveda, and these countless branches of the Vedic knowledge, this has not been really, codified in terms of the modern, the methodologies of teaching. I believe Dev Sanskrit Vishwavidyalaya is the first of its kind in the country, which has picked up the thread of revisiting or reinventing this super branch of the knowledge. Now, one may dispute when I call it a super branch of the knowledge, but if we go by the fine details, like basics starting from the zero to decimal to egg to dust to so many and so on. So the basics of the mathematics are there in the Vedic knowledge. That way, Professor Durgesh and this galaxy of the distinguished educationists, those who are participating in the webinar, they'll agree to that Vedic knowledge is no doubt a basics to the
all sort of a knowledge that we have in the domain of that we call a domain of education today. That way, then as I said, ki, let me take it an privilege to invite you all that Uttarakhand is such a, we call it a Devabhoomi. The reason why this university is called Dev Sanskrit Vishwavidyalaya, because this is primarily located in Uttarakhand. In Uttarakhand, we spiritually call it a Devabhoomi. So I believe if educationist, if the people around the world turn to this area studying the inherent the intellect of this area, the resources of this area, the Ayurveda of this area, the different herbs and plants, and you know, the high Himalayas, where even today the saints and sages take refuge for the enlightenment. So, of course, this can lead to a link. This can lead to the modern science and the Vedic science. Thank you. Thank you.
Professor Saxena. Hello. We welcome Dr. Swarna Sharma also. Professor Abhay Saxena, before I invite you, let me welcome Dr. Swarna Sharma. And I must give my compliments to Sri Munna Singh Chauhan ji for his very, very insightful, you know, this thoughts. And because from this government's perspective, he has given from Uttarakhand government side also, because we are looking forward for this kind of association in which so many intellectuals from around the world, they can contribute towards making, you know, not only this nation, humanity, but at the same time, Uttarakhand to be a truly a true knowledge hub. So thank you, sir, Sri Chauhan Sahab, for his very, 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 very luminary words of wisdom. He has always been, you know, by our side, always. So thank you so much. And we welcome Sri Chirag Desai. We welcome Vinita Raghuvanchim and Ankit Patel. We welcome Brij Mohan and Nancy Gupta, Nitin Manolkar. And I have a long list. So on behalf of Professor Saxena, on behalf of USERC, I welcome them all to this webinar. Now over to Professor Saxena.
So before we move ahead to the presentation, I would like to invite Ashutosh Bhatt sir to give a brief discussion about how the technology is, what the things are likely to be in the technological world, so that we can understand how the technology and computers and the Vedic science can be correlated together. So, Professor Ashutosh Bhatt sir.
Hello. Yeah. Umesh, please share the screen. Hello. Hello, sir. Am I audible?
Yes.
Hello.
Yes, you are.
Yes, you are, sir.
Okay, sir.
You are audible, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Professor Saxena, and thank you, Professor Pansar, and chief guest of the program, Professor Sri Munna Singh Chauhan ji. So I am talking about information technology. Actually, the information technology is a combination of computational technology and telecommunication technology. So basically, it is a combination of all these. This is user and processes, data, network, software, and computer. But today, we are talking about the digital revolution. And this is the time of robotics and industry 4.0. And we are moving towards cognitive system era. And we have lots of technology. We are in the age of Watson, intelligent computer system. This is a question answering machine, and it understands the natural languages, and it can extract knowledge from the subjective data. So now it is possible that we can extract meaning from the news and from the subjective data. And this is the time of OVIA and Ross intelligence. Ross is artificial intelligence lawyer of US. And now we are talking about convergence of different technology. That they are mobile technology, cloud technology, big data, social media, and natural communication. So technology is there, and we are developing technology by convergence of these technology. And during this crisis of COVID-19, mobile and social media is the lifeline, and we are giving our presence and existence using in this virtual world by this mobile and social media technology. We have lots of technologies, big data, artificial intelligence. We have robotics, advanced robotics, 3D printing, smart wearable, Internet of Things, and so many new technologies are there. And cloud is the backbone. And due to this cloud, we have lots of devices, lots of smart devices. They are so powerful. And e-learning is possible in this time. And universities and colleges are closed due to lockdown. And we have only this e-learning means. And we have huge amount of, massive amount of e-content. We have digital communication. We have lots of interfaces and many tutors in this virtual world. MOOCs is very powerful these days. We can learn and we can create any course. And data is a tsunami. And we are talking about big data. We have huge amount of climate information, social media data, and science data, GPS signals. And by this data, we are creating a big resource. And data which we are collecting up to 2013, we have collected up to 2013, that data we are collecting now within 5 or 10 minutes. And this data is few channels generates the data. So we are expecting this 35.2 gigabyte digital universe up to the end of this 2020. And we have large volume of data, large velocity of data. 2 minutes is too late now. And we have variety of data. So we are expecting this huge amount of data, or we are triggering new concept, and we have this big resource, and we are generating new idea by this big data. But on the other hand, we have the problem, and we are facing the crisis of climate change. We are facing the problem of this global warming, and so we have to move in this direction, and we have to preserve our old tradition. Or that's why we have to innovate towards this ethic informatics and in this area. So thank you very much. Thank you Professor Avais Saxena ji. And
okay, so here we go. Like, Om Joshi, can you share the screen over here? So, जिस विषय पे हम बात करने वाले हैं वो है वैदिक इन्फॉर्मेटिक्स. अब वैदिक इन्फॉर्मेटिक्स ही क्यों? क्योंकि शायद वो टेक्नोलॉजिकल री इंजीनियरिंग है वैदिक पर्सपेक्टिव में. टेक्नोलॉजी री इंजीनियरिंग, मैं शब्द बड़ी ईमानदारी से इसे यूज कर रहा हूँ, बिकॉज वेद में काफी कुछ चीजें हमारे पास मौजूद हैं जिन्हें हम दिखाने और समझाने की चीजें हम आराम से कर सकते हैं. तो आइए हम जरा नए तरीके से समझते हैं कि वैदिक इन्फॉर्मेटिक आखिर है तो है क्या. मैं शुरुआत एक मंत्र से करना चाहूंगा. ओम अग्नि मीले पुरोहितम यज्ञ सदैव मृतम होताराम रत्न धातम. ऋग्वेद का ये पहला सूत्र है, इसे सूक्त वन मंडल वन से था, और इसमें जो मूल में बताया गया है कि अग्नि स्वरूप ही परमात्मा है। यज्ञ में मैं अपनी आराधना करता हूँ या सृष्टि से पूर्व या सृष्टि के बाद जो कुछ भी है वो अग्नि हमें प्रदान करे, कुछ इस तरीके से कि हम आज वी आर जस्ट टॉकिंग अबाउट टू थिंग्स, ऑन द वन हैंड वी हैव अ साइंस दैट इज अ वैदिक साइंस, ऑन द अदर हैंड मॉडर्न टेक्नोलॉजी। तो अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ लाइक एज सेटिंग ऋग्वेद में एकम सद्वित्रा बहुधा वदन्ति, देयर आर मेनी वेज बट दे ऑल लीड टू वन सुपर कॉन्शियसनेस, वैदिक साइंस और वेदर वी टॉक अबाउट द मॉडर्न टेक्नोलॉजी, बोथ आर सपोज टू लीड टू ओनली वन वर्ड। And why I'm saying so, let's look about the word of Vedas. We all know they are the fourth perspective of Vedas. They are the two, they are Rig, Yajur, Sam, and later Athar was added. In the simple word, we can say the Ved is supposed to provide us Gyan. Samaschar, Achar, Sansan, or Paramatma. If you want to get Gyan, then you have to read Ved. Jeev, Jagat, or Maya, Brahma, if you want to know, then you have to read Ved. वेद सिर्फ एक सिंपल एक कैनवास नहीं है। अगर आप वैदिक लिटरेचर के एनवायरमेंट को देखें, वैदिक लिटरेचर के कैनवास को देखें, तो आपको संहिता भी मिलेंगे, ऋग्वेद, यजुर्वेद, सामवेद, अथर्ववेद मिलेंगे। If you look out on the Brahman, then they are ऐत्रेय, कौशिकी, दैत्रेय, शतपथ, जैमिनी। When you look out the Upanishads, they are enormous, ईशावास, केनो, प्रश्नो, कानो, मुनाक, तो तैत्रेय, and there are endless lists. And then look out the Vāṅmya Sahitya, it is as beautiful. And if you look up the Kal, Shik, Vyakaran, Nirkut, Chhan, Jyotish, Upved, and this shows that how much the literature is all about. I'll just take some slides because I can speak for hours, but I do feel so that we have to just confine the things so that all others can be incorporated. Look at this slide. That when you say that God has created Brahma, that Brahma has created the world, he has created one side Jeev and another side is Chakra. And in between of that, we have a mind. Is called illusion, and then we have a four type of gyan, the bhautik gyan, that is the vima, vigyan, gyat and agyat, daivik, that is related with the divinity, adhyatmik or adibhautik, tatvik, when you said it, that is the metaphysics, jan, maran, brahma, gyan, and then apaurushya, it is comes from the as environment, from the Ved, Upanishad, Puran, Aranya, and once we can see that we do have a knowledge warehouse. If you look out, we can have on the one hand side some knowledge sources known, some are unknown, some are rishi, and these are all collectively stored into the Aranyak, Shruti, Smriti, and then they are become a data warehouse, knowledge warehouse, and it can be accessed by anyone, Manishi, maybe Gurukul, maybe Sahita, maybe Samaj, Dev, Danav, Insan, everyone can approach it. So look out the canvas that we are looking for. Then the cloud of knowledge. We all know the computers very well. And then cloud computing infrastructure, platform, application, look at the environment. When you say that Vicharana is there, that means we have certain set of knowledge. When we say that we are likely to present it on something, that is a platform. And then all the new researches, collective researches, communication, all are a part of applications. So in brief, we can say, as Professor Ashutosh Bhatt has rightly said, that we are in the world of technology, that is moving from the internal world to external world. So that's why I said we have to define re-engineering the things. Look out. It's a paradigm shift from the conventional computing to the unconventional computing. अब ये नहीं है कि सिर्फ हम कन्वेंशनल कंप्यूटिंग की बात करेंगे, मैं आपको बताऊंगा कि कैसे इंडस्ट्री 5.0 में हम डिजिटल बुद्धों से एकाकार होने की कोशिश करेंगे। वर्ड ऑफ कंप्यूटिंग हम सबको पता है, मोस्ट ऑफ दिल्डा के स्टूडेंट्स और प्रोफेसर्स कंप्यूटिंग के हो, एंड देन वी हैव सम ब्यूटीफुल पीपल अक्रॉस द ग्लोब, श्री संजय सक्सेना जी हमारे साथ बोस्टन से हैं, उमा शंकर पांडे जी हैं अमेरिका से, हमारे पास में अमित पल्याल जी हैं, अमित कुमार पंडित जी हैं, ये सभी कंप्यूटर साइंस के विशेषज्ञ हैं और ये उन चीजों को बड़े अच्छे से समझते हैं कि राइट फ्रॉम द मॉर्फोलॉजिकल ऑपरेशन टू द नेचुरल लैंग्वेज प्रोसेसिंग we have immense. The question is, how does we will correlate both the strings? Like, agar aapko sahi shabdon mein samajhna hai, to ek taraf aapko Vedic knowledge rakhni padegi, aur dusri taraf modern technology rakhni padegi. Jab in dono ka sammishran hoga, hum use kahenge Vedic informatics. सरल शब्दों में मैं ऐसे आपसे कहूं कि जब हम चार्ल्स डार्विन संजय और धरतराष्ट्र इन सब को एक ही पैमाने में तोलें तो हम कहेंगे कि हम वैदिक इन्फॉर्मेटिक्स की बात कर रहे हैं। वैदिक विज्ञान में आधुनिक ज्ञान खंडों द्वारा प्रमाणित करने का प्रयास है। लाइक साइंस एंड वैदिक लिटरेचर इफ कैन बी कम ऑन द सेम प्लेटफॉर्म वी कैन से इट इज वैदिक इन्फॉर्मेटिक्स। सो लाइक आई जस्ट टेक सम सर्टेन एग्जांपल्स बिकॉज वी आर रनिंग आउट ऑफ टाइम because we have to redefine the artificial intelligence. Vedic system provides the four type of language, para, pashyanti, vani. Like your eyes can speak, your heart can speak, your soul can speak, and if you can use the speech recognition concept, then the things are likely to be happen in this world. Machine learning technology, like think if you can run the machines through your speed of mind, the weapons which has been used in the earlier side, and if we can use it like chip-based instrumentation, guided missiles, then the things are likely to happen in the more precise way. So that means we have to define artificial intelligence into another way. Moving ahead, like if we just look around the mobile computing, like we know Bala and Adibala. Right now we are all watching Ramayana, and there are the ballistic missiles, there are the various instruments which runs from the thought. So terrestrial ballistic missiles, they are the Vedic perspective. We also look into the Vaimanik Shastra. If you just turn around the certain pages of the Vaimanik Shastra, you can find n number of fuels over there. The type of vayuas which runs from your mind, they can change the position, calculate the enemy positions, and they works into the four dimensions. Data mining is a new concept. It's not new now, extraction of hidden knowledge, which is available into the nice set of formats. Now you can say that transcription or automatic knowledge database generation from Sanskrit to various language, like they are a global language. People are sitting here from the UK, say Pragya Govind is here. We can found the people from the KwaZulu-Natal, Professor Anish Kumar is there. So there are many local languages that are available in that particular part of world. Can we convert, can we transcript? And if we are able to do it so, then only the things are likely to happen. So then the thing is web mining. क्या हम कुछ ऐसा डेटा निकाल सकते हैं जो इंसान की सोच के लिए अच्छा हो? क्या हम कोई ऐसा डेटा निकाल सकते हैं जो पर्सनल ग्रोथ के लिए अच्छा हो, पेरेंटल ग्रोथ के लिए अच्छा हो, या सब्जेक्टिव नॉलेज के लिए अच्छा हो? अगर हम सोच सकते हैं तो ही शायद हमारा ये कोर कंप्यूटिंग या वैदिक इन्फॉर्मेटिक्स के ऊपर चर्चा करना सार्थक होगा। न्यूरल नेटवर्क की हम बात करें, क्या सुश्रुत के ग्रंथ, चारवा के ग्रंथ, धन्वंतरी का ब्रेन मॉडल, क्या इसे हम आर्टिफिशियल न्यूरल नेटवर्क से सिद्ध कर सकते हैं? संभव है, बहुत सरल संभव है। और हमने डीएसवीयू में अभी जो अगर हम कहें कि हमने मॉडल्स बनाए हैं तो वो बेसिकली स्ट्रेस मैनेजमेंट मॉडल, परफॉर्मेंस मॉडल, ऑर्गेनाइजेशन स्ट्रेस पे हमने काम किया हुआ है, और हमारे प्रोफेसर नवीन उन्होंने काफी अच्छा इस पे काम किया हुआ है। सो लोग पूछ सकते हैं कि सर हम फ्यूचरिस्टिक जिसे हम कह सकते हैं कि वैदिक इन्फॉर्मेटिक्स में आखिर क्या करेंगे? क्या हम मन की मैपिंग कर सकते हैं? वो कौन से पैरामीटर होंगे जो माइक्रोकॉस्मोस से मैक्रोकॉस्मोस की यात्रा कर सकते हैं? चंद घंटों में, चंद निमिष में हम वहां से मूव कर लें? क्या टेली ट्रांसपोर्टेशन पॉसिबल है? क्या भविष्य में जाना और पास में जाना संभव है? ये वैदिक साइंस में लिखा हुआ है। सच बात तो यही है कि हमने वेदों को ठीक से पढ़ा ही नहीं, या तो हमें किसी ने समझाया ही नहीं, ना ही उसकी वही उपयोगिता समझाई। क्या वेदों को मल्टीलिंगुअल बनाया जा सकता है? या उसमें निश्चित ज्ञान को यूबिलिटीज कंप्यूटिंग के द्वारा सिद्ध किया जा सकता है? सामान्य वर्षा के लिए किन मंत्रों का सहारा लेना होगा? और अगर हम बोले रहे अतिवृष्टि को रोकने के लिए मंत्र होंगे, सही है, कोरोना के रोकने के लिए भी कोई मंत्र हो जाते तो क्या बात होती? इंसान की सोच में पॉजिटिविटी इंक्रीज करनी है तो कौन सी यज्ञ अनुष्ठान करें, कौन सा जप करें, कौन सा तप करें? वो कौन सी सिद्धि थी जिससे अणिमा लघिमा महिमा का प्रयोग होता था? शरीर से हवा से हल्का करना, बिंदु से आकाश से जोड़ना, और पानी पर चलने वाला विज्ञान आखिर कौन सा था? आग में बहुत सी चीजें हमें विस्तृत से हमें समझाई गई। तो मैं बातों को समेटते हुए कहता हूँ कि ये कुछ कंसेप्ट है जो हमें देखना चाहिए। आखिर इस कंसेप्ट में अगर हम ध्यान से देखें तो एक तरफ हम चार्ल्स बेबेज को ले रहे हैं और एक तरफ हम डिजिटल बुद्ध को ले रहे हैं। हम सिमेंटिक से समाधि की यात्रा पे जा रहे हैं सर। कन्वेंशनल कंप्यूटिंग सन 36 में शुरू हुई थी और सन 30 आते आते हम टेक सेजेस से मिल रहे होंगे। स्विचिंग सर्किट्स हुए, मशीन के इंस्ट्रक्शंस फॉलो करते रहे। 2016 आते आते हम सॉफ्ट कंप्यूटिंग पे काम करने लगे, मशीन लर्निंग, इंडस्ट्री 4.0, इंट्यूटिव कंप्यूटिंग। अब तो डिजिटल बुद्धों से मिलने की बात है। कंप्यूटर साइंस के निष्णात विद्वानों बी रेडी टू मीट द डिजिटल बुद्धा सिंपल 2030 एंड इफ यू आर एबल टू डू इट सो देन द थिंग्स आर लाइकली टू बी हैपन इन मोस्ट प्रिसाइज वे सो जस्ट आई वांट टू ऐड वन लास्ट स्लाइड दैट अ थॉट कैन क्रिएट अ न्यू वर्ल्ड इट इज ऑलवेज इमॉर्टल व्हाई आई एम सेइंग सो बिकॉज when I said that, that's why it is important. Udar charitta naam tu vasudhai kutumbakam. We all are one family. Today, all because of the technology, all because of you, sir, all because of the professor Pansakwar, all because of the people sitting across the globe, they are sitting together for what? For the welfare of each and every one. तो जब जब हम जिंदगी को इस तरीके से देखने की कोशिश करेंगे तो मैं समझता हूँ कि हम शायद अपने आप को नए स्वरूप में भी निखारेंगे चीजों को बेहतर भी करेंगे और शायद देव संस्कृति विश्वविद्यालय या बिरला इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ अप्लाइड साइंसेज या जितने भी युवा टीचर्स और रिसर्च स्कॉलर्स हम सब से जुड़े हुए हैं मैं उनसे एक ही विनती करूंगा कि आप अपनी चीजों को फिर से नए सिरे से देखना सीखिए जिस दिन आप नए सिरे से देखेंगे आप देखेंगे कि हम अथाह ज्ञान के समुद्र में अपने आप को स्थापित किए हुए हैं कि ज्ञान सिर्फ किताबों तक सीमित ना रहे व्यावहारिकता के धरातल पर जब ये उतरेगा तो संपूर्ण जो विषय है वो एक परिवार होगा सुखी होगा समन्वित होगा इन्हीं बातों के साथ मैं अपनी वाणी को विराम देता हूँ ओम शांति शांति शांति
प्रोफेसर अभय सक्सेना के इस सुंदर विचारों के बाद आपको लगता होगा कि उन्होंने जो ये रीडिफाइन किया है ये अपने आप में हो सकता है कि एक नया वे फॉरवर्ड हो दिस इज मस्ट टू रिक्वायर्ड एम आई ऑडिबल हेलो ओके सो मुझे इससे अभी ध्यान आ रहा था जो प्रोफेसर सक्सेना ने कहा मुन्ना सिंह चौहान साहब का एसोसिएशन डीआरडीओ से है जो हमारी बहुत ही प्रतिष्ठित संस्था है उससे अभी जो हमारी मिसाइल वुमेन ऑफ इंडिया हैं टेसी थॉमस जो अग्नि और उसके अग्नि से जुड़ी रही हैं प्रोजेक्ट डायरेक्टर हैं वो अभी आई हुई थी एंड यू सर का एक कार्यक्रम था हमने स्पेस कन्वेंशन किया था सम टाइम इन फरवरी अबाउट टू मंथ्स बैक देन शी वाज टॉकिंग अबाउट आर्यभट्ट एंड शी वाज टॉकिंग अबाउट भास्करन और ये बट वैदिक एरा प्रीडेट्स ऑल दीज वंडरफुल मैथमेटिशियन एंड ऑल दोज पीपल दोज हु वर इन एस्ट्रोनॉमी दोज हु वर इन मेडिसिन शी वाज आल्सो टॉकिंग अबाउट कि जो हमारे यहाँ का इतना ट्रेडिशनल विजडम रहा है कि उसको किस तरह से हाउ कैन वी ट्रांसलेट दैट पर्टिकुलर इंफॉर्मेशन हाउ कैन वी not demystify but decodify the whole thing and that could come to you know to utility and that to fruitful fruition finally which could somehow enrich not only our universities institutions could give us insight so that was very very important for us but ISRO could do that DRDO could do that all our premier institution they are making use of all those wonderful knowledge systems that we had so since professor Saxena is also working in these domains of artificial neural networks and artificial intelligence and about a few months back we came up with a book on IoT different dimensions of IoT so we co-authored a book and he came up with so many different ideas and those ideas are implementable ideas doable ideas and with the Birla Institute of Applied Sciences we have in fact at USAC we could translate all those ideas into action those devices are working models now meaning thereby if we have all those systems in place those traditional systems in place and we have all these workable models now because soft computing gives us this facility this flexibility of course through which we can blend and in different time dimensions these time dimensions are about 2-3 thousands apart but through blending not only we can use
these things, but we can take them to insightful fruition. This is my whole idea. Thank you very much, Professor Saxena sir. So now I'll invite Swapnil. Will it be? Swapnil has a wonderful presentation. But before, if anybody wants to come in with his or her comment, there are so many very, very learned professors with us. If they want to just chip in with their ideas, and then we can have a wonderful presentation from a researcher's point of view. Swapnil will come forward with this presentation. And again, that is an integration of Vedic knowledge system and informatics, that is technologies, all technologies encapsulated. So if we have anyone who would like to come in, and welcome he is. And else I'll request Swapnil to come up with his presentation, please.
Thank you so much, sir. Good afternoon to all of you. It is a pleasure to have over here and presenting my opinion on this. So today I'm going to discuss about the scope of Vedic informatics. So in the overview, first of all, those who are very crucial and want to dive deeper into the Vedas, there is a caution for them. I will also discuss some prerequisites for the seekers, and we will discuss some ancient gems, those who are having extraordinary scientific temperament. And ultimately the objective of the Vedic informatics. And also we'll also try to differentiate science with wisdom. So let's start. So about Vedas, the first question arises, what are the Vedas? It is the primary scriptures of Hinduism known as Vedas. The word Veda is derived from the root word Vid, that means to know. The next question arises, what they teach? They teaches the highest truth ever known to the man. The next question arises, how broad they are. So there is a shloka in the Manusmriti. It means that in the past, present and future related knowledge is based on Vedas. So there is an X factor with the Vedas. What is that X factor? According to the Acharya Sayan, Krishna Yajurved, he has mentioned in that the knowledge about an object that cannot be derived from observation and estimated logical proof can also be taken from Vedas. It is the Vedic element of Vedas. Next, we'll discuss the eternity of the Veda. Maharshi Vedvyasa has mentioned in the Mahabharata that at the beginning of universe, Almighty emanates divine sound, which is immortal, that regulate various activities of this world. This might seem impossible with the logical brain, but we can take an example that we can assess all the worldly information available on the web through our client machines. Even if we turn off the client, it doesn't imply that the loss of information, but it is still reside there in respective servers or the cloud repository. The similar way, Vedas are also for the eternal. They never can be destroyed. Then what is about the complete or the wholeness of the Vedas? As per the Upanishad, if from the complete is taken out, the complete still remains. It is the Purna Madha Purna Midam Purnata Purna Mudashyate. Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Here is a little bit hierarchy of the Vedic literature, in which the Vedas are included Rig Ved, Yajur Ved, Sam Ved and Atharva Ved. These four classes are further divided into Samhitas, Brahmanas, Aranyakas, Upanishad. And beside the Vedas, there are also Upvedas. From each Ved, like for the Rig Ved, there is Ayurveda. For the Yajur Ved, there is a Dhanur Ved. For the Sam Ved, there is a Gandharva Ved, and from the Atharva Ved, there is Arthashastra. In the parallel to this, Vedangas are there, and their specific classification. There is a prerequisite for the seekers. The sages of the divine culture has two essential recommendations for the readers of the Vedas. The very first is reverence. The reader must have reverence because the knowledge in the Vedas is highly encrypted form that may confuse the reader's mind. And the second thing we require is immense practice. It is required to attain the higher realm of consciousness to interpret the truth hidden behind the hymns of Vedas. Besides this, in order to get the specific knowledge, one must abide of the discipline required to raise the practitioner up to the desired level. Vedic mantras encloses deep discipline of the super consciousness. Vocabulary and grammar is merely the outermost shell of this hidden treasure. Let us have a look over the Maharshi Panini, one of the ancient gem with the extraordinary scientific temperament. He has gained the reputation of being a Sanskrit grammarian, worked on phonetics, phonology, and morphology, thereby providing a complete and comprehensive grammar for Sanskrit. The word Sanskrit means complete or the perfect. He can also be a first programmer. The world has identified the merit of his grammar, which in many ways has helped the present-day understanding of the natural language processing and artificial intelligence. The Panini's work is largely compiled in his treatise called Ashtadhyayi. So here the grammar that he specified is, at the surface level, the uttered sentence is converted to the Vibhakti level, then it's put to the Karak level, and finally it puts to the semantic level, where we can get what the speaker has in mind. The ultimate objective of the Vedic informatics is the attraction of wisdom, and it will ultimately help to attain the higher order of the wisdom, that is self-realization. Here I have tried to propose a model for the wisdom recommendation system. Here at the lower level, all the Vedas and Upanishads are there. The data processing will be happened through the translation, which can be done using the Sanskrit parser or the interpreter. After that, they can be structured well into the information, and using this knowledge model to get an insight, and using insight in distinct situation, using distinct context. And perspective will provide the direction, and ultimately we will reveal some principle on the basis of which we can take some decisions. So from downward to upward, the level of understanding goes on increasing. So science, what is science? Science is organized knowledge, whereas the wisdom is organized life. India's greatest export today is non-material information technology, but I'm quite sure tomorrow will be the sustainable Vedic informatics. Thank you so much.
So this is non-material information technology. I am coming across this term for the first time, and this is quite an amazing moment. Because this is so very important, and sometime in as I recall, in 1996, you know, turning this there was this
जी आपकी तो आ रही है प्रोफेसर पंत साहब की नहीं आ रही
जब तक सर शायद कुछ ऑडियो का है मैं एमिनेंट प्रोफेसरों से कहूंगा कि वो थोड़ा सा चिप इन उमाशंकर पांडे जी वैसे जो न्यूजर्सी से हैं मैं उनसे रिक्वेस्ट करूंगा कि वो थोड़ा सा ऑडियंस को एड्रेस करें
थैंक यू अभय जी दिस वाज अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग सेमिनार आई वुड से because it's very interesting because if you look at what Google is doing it's basically a compilation of knowledge where people are giving inputs you enter your stuff in Google you create wikis and all Google does is creates a search that's so when we look at Vedas if I look at from a application point of view I, for example, let's say I have a problem with XYZ. Then I go to somebody and he looks at my chart, he looks at my something and he thinks something and comes with a solution. That's very fascinating to a lot of people. So the question comes, can I put that into a program? Can I actually put it into a computer program or something which is where we have a tremendous database Vedic database like Swapnil said right Vedas are highly cryptic and it depends upon who is interpreting it so what is the right interpretation for it so that's a very questionable thing because your interpretation could be very different than mine so the authenticity of the interpretation is very, very, very important, especially in this age of Googles and webs, in this technology age, where misinformation travels faster than the real information. So coming back to here, so I always thought of creating or having some kind of a massive database where all the Vedas, what is learning from Vedas, can that be classified? And I always wondered about that. And one of the, and then on the one end, we have from applications perspective, let's say I have an app which says, okay, my personal problems. So I say, okay, today I'm feeling XYZ and based on this, what is the solution for it? Because today and going forward people are becoming very impatient and the new generation is becoming very impatient and they want answers like today they want answers this minute because with all this AI machine learning things are becoming much 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 faster which is making us very impatient so the question comes if I have a problem do I have a solution and we always say Vedas is all the solutions. Vedas can do everything possible. But the question comes, how do I get it done? How do I know where it is? So, I mean, it is a really very fascinating, at least for me. And I will keep on exploring in this area. And I'm very thankful to Professor Saxena and Swapnil to share their vision in the slides because to me it's a constant learning and if we can come up with some kind of a framework or a platform from implementation perspective consortium which says okay this is the Vedic informatic alpha project I wouldn't say even beta it's an alpha project where it says okay we take maybe one part of Veda and try to classify and come up with some practical or maybe it already exists my ignorance you know maybe it already exists but I mean if I look at IITs you know I mean IITs have translated or put everything all the Vedas online I mean I was looking at it once but now so I think it's a seminars are very very good they're really eye-opener but I think we should have if we can come up with at the end what next action items that That will be really, really very, very interesting and fascinating for me. Thank you, yeah. Professor Saxena.
Thank you very much for being enlightening us. We do have a professor from South Africa, Professor Anish Kumar Maharaj. I would like to request you, Professor, to kindly enlighten us with your some words.
And Prof, can I chip in for a second? Yeah. What I was saying, because as Uma Shankar Pandey, he was saying, do we need some Watson kind of Vedic Watson for, you know, interpreting our Vedic information? So when we can have a Watson, you know, an IBM Watson doing wonders all around, giving us newer interpretation, virtually we see any time round. So can we have something like Vedic Watson? Can we have this kind of consortium, as rightly he's saying? Can we have an intelligent way of, and super intelligent way of, you know, codifying all these wonderful, wonderful aspects of Vedas? So this can be possibly a takeaway from this webinar. Please, over to you. This was just an idea.
Thank you, sir, for the updating. Professor Hardik Joshi is here with us from Gujarat, Gandhinagar, Gujarat. So Hardik bhai, can you just chip in for a certain words from your side?
Yeah, I hope I am audible. Greetings to all of you. And yeah, I appreciate the PPTs that you shared with us, the presentations of Professor Abhayji and Swapnilji. It's an excellent way of, we do require brainstorming. And since Vedas are knowledge in terms of dhatus, so each word may have so many meanings. And converting the Ved into wisdom is not only important, but it's a mammoth task. And current machine learning models may not directly fit into it. We have to come out with various wisdom-oriented tools and technologies so that each word may have different meanings, and we can harness the meanings and organization of mantras so that it can be spread into different aspects. So the same mantra can be used for a lifestyle, same mantra can be used as a Ayurvedic Aushadhi, and so on. So I feel, yes, we do indeed need proper systems to create information systems. Thank you so much, Abhayji.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Sir, we do have Pragya Govind from Leicester. So Pragya, can you just chip in for a while? How you are feeling? So the need of this Vedic informatics and how the things are looking at a youth perspective. Ms. Pragya Govind.
Pranam, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Hello. So I have a question. How can we market the Vedic informatics in the Western world so they can understand in today's society within the UK youth?
Okay. Professor Brent, you want to answer this question?
Yes, because Pragya, what we have seen is, and especially, you know, after this COVID-19, we have realized how at times, I should not say juvenile, but how inadequate, you know, this entire science that we have created, you know, it lasts about 400-500 years. So it may be medicine, it may be other technologies, but the gyan part that all our previous speakers, they have been mentioning, that is very important. Because if humanity has to survive, if it has to last, then we got to be in sync with nature. And then in order to be in sync with the nature, we got to, you know, we got to have
at least this is what I think, we got to have at least some idea of our Vedic system, traditional system. When we say Vedic, does not necessarily mean that we got to know each and every slok or we got to recite, but at least we got to assimilate that very essence of life that this nature has given us, this Rig Veda or this Gayatri Mantra that we enchanting of Gayatri Mantra. This is nothing but, you know, this upasana of this mighty sun. So of who is the king of our solar system. So that realization and that affirmation is very important. The Western world, yes, it could see that affluence, it could see all that, you know, the material surrounding. That all happened, but when we say how small all those things are in front of, especially at times of these pandemic, possibly this realization will come, and if this blending happens, it is all the more good for the society, be it Western society, be it Eastern society, but for the whole world. This is what I think, and this realization will eventually come, and it is. It is coming very, very fast. Does this answer this query of yours? Am I audible?
Yes. Yes.
Hello.
Thank you very much for your answer.
Yeah, Professor Saxena, please go ahead. Is he audible, Professor Saxena?
No, he is not.
He is not. Can he be told, Dr. Nautiyal, can he be told he is not audible? Possibly he got to unmute his audio. Got to. Swapnil, yes, Professor Saxena has to unmute, yeah. And maybe can I request anyone of you to please come in with your comments with regard to what Pragya asked and what Uma Shankarji also he pointed out, that this deciphering this basic this essence of Vedas into knowledge and finally translating them into wisdom. Will it be possible for us, and how are we going to go about it? Can we have our learned professors, can they come in please, any one of you? And then I'll ask Dr. Nautiyal and Dr. M.P. Thapyal, so they can also come in please.
Pranam to everybody on the call. I would just like to appreciate the distinction that Swapnil made about the material and non-material informatics.
Yes,
the key thing about the Vedic thought is that it requires a stream of consciousness to really reach to the core meaning of the Vedic message or essence. I would like to put a metaphor here, that when an athlete uses a pole vault to make a high jump, the pole has to be left behind. So we have to keep a goal in mind, that all this approach to informatics is like that vault, that pole that an athlete is using to go to the other side, but it has to be left behind. There is no way that you can there is no way that you can really take or carry the pole on the other side that you want to reach to that expansive. So we have to differentiate between man, buddhi and the chetana, and there has to be a understanding of the model of the akash that goes, that sthula akash, sukshma akash and the chidakash. And Vedas basically come from the dimension of Chidakash and help us to go cross over to the other side. So just a placeholder when we formulate our thesis and try to make use of it.
Yes.
Professor Durgesh, am I audible?
Yes, you are. Durgesh, please.
Look, I have certain questions. In fact, I got lost in this entire discussion. Vedas, of course, is a Vedic study in the Vedic literature. Very voluminous and very difficult to contain in any kind of a discussion. My immediate, as I said in the beginning, I'm a working politician. And as I said in the beginning, I'm a part of the lawmaking mechanism of the system. As I said in the beginning, I'm a part of the policy making. You know, as Dr. Abhay Saxena said in the beginning, the format of this Vedic informatics can we really label some, mechanism where the structured studies of the certain important scientific and technological things, which has been clearly mentioned in the Vedas, can it be substantiated scientifically in the modern days? Can it be substantiated by the modern day science? If we succeed in doing so, then of course the brightest of bright brain will come to the area. The biggest problem is, as most of the learned speakers have pointed out, in Vedas, one word has got a different meaning. And yes. when it comes to interpreting the Vedas, then I have a different interpretation, Dr. Durgesh has a different, Dr. Swapnil has a different, and Dr. Saxena has a different interpretation. And finally, people say that this knowledge is not codified. So, from the Uttarakhand's point of view, as I said, this is a Devbhumi. I look forward to a day, especially when I request Professor Abhay Saxena, keep this Sanskrit Vishwavidyalaya. Can we really codify this traditional knowledge? We call it a Vedic knowledge or a traditional knowledge. Can we really codify it and come about a structured study of this Vedic or the traditional knowledge? Please.
Professor Saxena, Professor Abhay Saxena, are you? Can you? Yeah, please go ahead.
Thank you, sir. And I think this is the really need of the hour. Like as you said rightly, how to codify the Vedas in the right perspective. As I said it earlier, that Eka Vipra Bhavda Vadanti. Paramatma to ek hi hai, sir. Usko samajhne ke arth alag alag ho sakte hain. Chetna ke kis dharatal pe hum khade hue hain, वहां से हमारा सूरज अलग दिखेगा। मैं आपकी बात से अच्छा सहमत हूँ कि चारों लोगों की चारों ही अलग अलग सोच होगी, पर एक प्रोफेसर होने के नाते, एक पॉलिटिशियन होने के नाते, एक ज्ञानी होने के नाते हम सबका दायित्व है कि वेद के लाइक वी आर जस्ट कमिंग अप ए स्मॉल बुक दैट इज इंट्रोडक्शन टू वेदास। लाइक ऐसा नहीं कि किताबें नहीं है, ऐसा नहीं है कि साइंटिफिक एस्पेक्ट में वेदास को नहीं लिखा गया, पर हमारे लिए कौन सी चीजें आवश्यक हैं हमें पहले प्रायोरिटाइज वो करना पड़ेगा। बेस्ड ऑन जैसे मैं कंप्यूटर साइंस का मेंबर हूं तो सर मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि एआई से जोड़ करके मैं अपनी रिसर्चेस करूं तो मुझे ज्यादा बेहतर अच्छा लगेगा। समवन लुक्स फॉर द एएनएन, समवन लुक्स फॉर द वेरियस एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ द कंप्यूटेशनल साइंस, बट द कोर थिंग इज दैट द नॉलेज इज इटर्नल इन नेचर एंड इफ यू एबल टू लाइक जैसे सर ने कहा ना, संजय सक्सेना सर ने, कि आपको पोल को छोड़ के आगे बढ़ना पड़ेगा। हमें भी उन जो पुराने सोच है या हमारी जिन चीजों से हम बंधते हैं उनको सोच करके आगे बढ़ना पड़ेगा। साइंटिफिक एस्पेक्ट हर चीज का हो सकता है, बट इट डिपेंड्स हाउ द कैपेसिटी यू हैव, हाउ द नॉलेज सेट यू हैव, हाउ यू कैन एक्सप्लेन द थिंग्स। मे बी प्रोफेसर पंत कैन ऐड ऑन सर्टेन थिंग्स।
नहीं, ये देखिए मूल प्रश्न यही है जो चौहान साहब ने कहा है। हमारी पूरी भारतीय मनीषा फॉर 3-4 thousand ईयर्स ऑफ दिस नॉलेज विजडम ट्रेडिशंस दैट वी हैव ऑलवेज चेरिश्ड,
कि हमारे पास जो वो चीज थी, क्या हमारे पास, हम जिस समय उसको साइंटिफिक बेसिस है कहते हैं या उसका ट्रांसलेशन होने की बात करते हैं, पॉसिबली वी लुक एट द होल थिंग यू नो फ्रॉम दिस दिस पर्टिकुलर मॉडर्न साइंस विच हैपेंस टू बी दिस वेस्टर्न साइंस सिस्टम विद अस विच प्रिवेल्स विद अस फॉर लास्ट अबाउट 400-500 ईयर्स ऑफ साइंस, जो ये वाला हमारे पास पूरा का पूरा साइंटिफिक चीजें हैं जिसको हमने देखा हुआ है, जैसा उन्होंने कहा कि क्या वो डार्विन का है या वो गैलीलियो के पर्सपेक्टिव्स ने हमने सोचा, ये सारी चीजें। लेकिन जो वो लोग जो चीजें वैदिक हैं जो हम कह रहे हैं, ये कहा गया है कि जो मंत्र हैं, जो हमारे पास ऋचाएं हैं, जो पूरे के पूरे चार वेदों से निकलती हुई आगे की पूरी ज्ञान की श्रृंखला है, उसने चाहे वो इंडस वैली में हो और चाहे पूरी की पूरी आगे की हमारी मानव समाज है, सारी चीजें हैं, उसमें प्रभाव डाला है। अब उसको हम किस तरह से वैज्ञानिक आधार पर सिद्ध कर सकते हैं कि वेदर दे हैड दिस इक्वेशन इन माइंड, विच इक्वेशन स्टिल परसिस्ट, या किस तरह का क्या 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 इक्वेशनिंग रही है, क्या उसका फॉर्मेट रहा है, क्या फ्रेमवर्क रहा है, पॉसिबली वी डोंट नो। लेकिन हम क्या इस पोजीशन में, आपका बिल्कुल ठीक बात है, क्या हम इस क्या हम इस पोजीशन में हैं कि हम उसका ठीक तरह से डिसाइफर कर पाए, हम उसके हम ये कह पाए कि उसका इंटरप्रिटेशन यही था, क्योंकि कई बार सक्सेना साहब ने भी कहा, पांडे जी ने भी कहा कि उसका इंटरप्रिटेशन वो बड़ा सब्जेक्टिव सा हो जाता है कि आपका इंटरप्रिटेशन एक है, मेरा इंटरप्रिटेशन एक है, सक्सेना जी का इंटरप्रिटेशन एक है। क्या हम इंफॉर्मेटिक्स का इस्तेमाल करके क्या कुछ ऐसा हो सकता है?
दुर्गेश, व्हेन दिस सिचुएशन कम्स अबाउट देन पीपल शिफ्ट फ्रॉम वैदिक नॉलेज टू देन दे सिंपली स्टार्ट ब्लेंडिंग इट एज अ माइथोलॉजी एंड दे स्टॉप डिस्कसिंग द बेसिक्स ऑफ द नॉलेज एंड दे शॉर्टली कॉल इट अ माइथोलॉजी। सो दैट इज व्हाई देयर द टाइम हैज कम अबाउट व्हेन वी नीड टू एस्टैब्लिश अ कोरिलेशन बिटवीन the knowledge that is substantiated and what has been said and done in the Vedic knowledge and the Vedic times. This is what I am trying to say.
Chauhan sir, this is Sanjay.
No. I have one comment to make, and that is, this is something which I learned over a period of time, and that is the core interpretation, chahe koi bhi ho, whatever the interpretation could be, but that interpretation is the ultimate truth for that particular moment. So we always say ki agar koi cheez sahi hai kisi bhi samaj ke liye to wo truth ho jata, wo sahi mana jata hai. Ab jaise ki agar kisi ne kisi ko chakku maar diya ya banduk se kisi ko maar diya to ek koi bolega murder kiya, dusra bolta hai ki ye kya bolte hain soldier hai, तो एक खुशबो बना देते हैं। लेकिन अल्टीमेटली इट्स, तो इंस्टेड ऑफ लुकिंग एट द कोर मीनिंग, लिटरल मीनिंग, कॉन्टेक्स्ट बिकम्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट देयर। सो इट इज ऑल सब्जेक्टिव तो है, बट द कॉन्टेक्स्ट। और फिर हमने यही सीखा है अभी तक कि जो भी किसी भी सिचुएशन में जो भी वैल्यूज आर यूज करें and aur usse agar samaj uthta hai, so that is the right thing to do. So maybe the one of the things Vedic informatic consolidation of ideas and all that can bring this key wherever there is a difference of opinions, the mool question comes, what is the right thing to do which will lift the society at that particular moment? And because that is the ultimate truth, it doesn't matter what happened in the past or in the future, the truth is today there is a coronavirus, what is the right thing to do? You know, it doesn't matter ki to vedon mein bola ki quarantine ho jao, unhone mantra to de diya quarantine ka, lekin quarantine ka matlab aapko main kaun samjhayega? So samjhane wala koi bolta hai ki, you know, that's the thing. So this is what my whole point is when I say solution of problem. So it is very important that all the learned people, not from one sect of life, from everywhere, come together and come up with the, like, you know, okay, is situation mein ye ho sakta hai. And I think this is where artificial intelligence, machine learning can play a very massive role. And this is a self-learning system, because in one particular situation, how what is the right thing to do, in the other particular situation what is the right thing to do. For example, हम लोग कहते हैं vegetarian, you go to Alaska जहाँ पर कुछ होता ही नहीं है, तो वहाँ वो vegetarian नहीं है वहाँ पर. So then what is the right thing to do? They still have to survive, you know. तो कहने का मतलब है कि जो नॉलेज तो है हमारे पास में, उसके solutions भी हमें मालूम है. मैं आपको बहुत ही सिंपल चीज बताता हूँ. हम लोग कर्म कांड देखते हैं यहाँ पर, लोग पवित्रीकरण, सबसे पहले पवित्रीकरण का मंत्र लोग बोलते हैं, लेकिन मतलब कोई नहीं समझाता क्योंकि मे बी उनको भी नहीं मालूम. तो किसी ने मेरे को बोला कि द बेसिक मंत्र इज बी ऑनेस्ट. सो वेरी सिंपल रिलेशन, एक मंत्र का वेरी सिंपल इंग्लिश कि बी ऑनेस्ट. जहां ऑनेस्ट बात आ गई तो समझ में आ गई सारी बात एकदम से. सो दैट्स व्हाट माय होल पॉइंट इज कि कैन वी कम अप विद सम काइंड ऑफ ए सिस्टम वेयर ऑल दिस interpretations can be very simply, they can be translated into very simple language to understand. And I think that, and purane time mein aur jitne bhi upanishad bane, smritiyan bani, ye sab, I think this was the idea ki kathaen itni bani, purani kathaen ka idea yahi tha ki vedic mantron ko, vedic sutron ko kis tarike se jan jan ke liye hum pahuncha sake. That's all I wanted to share.
I want to make a quick comment on the question of Sri Chauhanji. Every discipline of knowledge has its own methods and instruments. I think we make a mistake of using the methods and instruments of science as we know it. Means we sometimes start treating science as a religion. That's a wrong approach. So the right way is that we should find, we should identify our own methods of Vedic knowing and the instruments of those knowing. And every discipline, like a instrument of astronomy, cannot be used to study the microbiology, and the methods of microbiology cannot be applied to the stream of astronomy. So likewise, we should not be mixing up the two methods of the modern science or Western science to the Vedic science. We have to be very careful about this mix up, and that creates a lot of confusion and problem in deciphering the knowledge. So we should stick with our methods of knowledge and instrument of knowledge. Like Swami Vivekananda says that the method of knowledge, instrument of our knowledge is our mind, and that instrument has to be calibrated the right way. So again, coming to the multiple interpretations of a particular mantra, yes, it is based on the state of mind, tuning of the mind, proper tuning, and the state of the consciousness of the observer. But like science is about observation and reproducing empirical data, likewise our rishis and our methods of knowing have been also able to reproduce that observation. But it is a subjective observation. But two rishis, when they talk to each other, they can validate that yes, this observation is valid using this method of knowing. So that those methods have to be very carefully identified and understood, and training must be formulated, I think.
Thank you. No, it is because Saxena ji or Pandey ji, and ye theek baat aa rahi hai, but something very interesting is happening, because we cannot go back in time, you know, to the Vedic age, and Chauhan ji cannot contest election in Vedic times again. We cannot go back. go back in time. We don't have this time machine. But yes, virtually we can enter. This is what I am saying. Virtually we can, because now we have this technological strength, and we, as we say, this informatics is nothing but informationing. It's a verb basically, and it means action. So we can go back in time. If we are not going back in time, at least whatever we have, database to mantra to whatever we have, sounds, richa, whatever, return and this oration part. So we can start interpreting.
I read in one of the paper written by Professor Saxena that Sanjay of the Mahabharata, he was, you know, that in visualizing the battlefield situation. So what was it like? Yes. It was a wireless transmission, or it was a communication through wires or without wires. So ultimately, that has been correlated with the modern day technology, because it has come about through.
Yes. So we have
at this especially COVID-19 has given us this opportunity, because Vedic times I don't know, but US, whether US was there or New Jersey was there, we don't know, but certainly we do know that this Indian subcontinent was here, and we had, and after that we had Indus Valley and so on and so forth. We had all these civilizations were there. So what we can do, we have all these information, we can start, if we have something with us, we can start working something, you know, on and over them, whatever we have, whatever interpretation we have. Yes, intentions are noble, because Dev Sanskriti University happens to be the epitome of all these learnings, and they keep doing such a wonderful work. So through this webinar also, we have galaxy of people around, and we can have linkages also. And Uttarakhand is already the Science Education Research Center, our center. We are already, and there are number of people, the students across, those who are keenly interested. They want to work in this domain. They are really interested. They want to know. They have this quest. They have this desire. They want to know what this all was. And rightly you are saying, when we say mythology and everybody just laughs it off at times. So we got to have solid scientific basis that these are there, when we can talk about. So because now we are saying, yes, those were all sciences, and those had very solid foundations. So can we have something of that sort? So we will be looking forward to that aspect also. Over to Professor Saxena. Maybe we can have other speakers, they can chip in.
Yes, we have some professors across the globe. Professor Nara is there from University of Malaysia. Professor Nara, can you chip in for a while so that we can be illuminated by your words?
Hello, good afternoon, good evening to everybody. Can you hear me?
Good evening.
Yeah, yes, we can hear.
Okay. What I appreciate is Professor Abhay and Swapnil has compiled such a distinguished group of researchers and dignitaries all together in one forum. I think it's a wonderful opportunity for me to join. And I just want to say that today I feel that I myself am a kind of a beginner. I'm just listening to try to understand. And what I can say is there are two different areas that we are looking at. One is Vedic science, and the other is the science of informatics or informations. And at the moment, there are many models in informatics that we are familiar with. And what we have for the Vedas is we know its potential, but the models, many of it are sometimes too abstract. So what we are going to need is we're going to have to look at models that will allow us to relate between these two. And well, we can start in either directions. And what I believe we will end up getting is new models that will enrich and add value to the existing scientific systems. And this is really my hope and my wish that such sessions will be able to produce in the long run.
Oh, yeah. Thank you very much, Professor. Sir, हमारे साथ प्रोफेसर अनिश कुमार महाराज भी हैं साउथ अफ्रीका से. सो प्रोफेसर अनिश कुमार जी, कैन यू जस्ट चिप इन फॉर अ व्हाइल सो दैट वी ऑल बी बेनिफिटेड फ्रॉम योर थॉट्स.
नमस्ते एवरीवन. आई वाज लुकिंग एट स्वप्निल्स मॉडल डाटा प्रोसेसिंग व्हिच रिलाइड ऑन द ट्रांसलेशन ऑफ द वेदास. I don't know Sanskrit, but my understanding is it's very technical. I've seen work done by the Infinity Foundation. They are doing research on the translation of the Vedas. In one of the videos, I saw Rajiv Malhotra indicate that there are interpretations done by Pollock. I think Pollock was funded by InfoSystems. And a lot of the interpretations seem to be incorrect, but those are the interpretations that the Western world uses. Thank you.
Professor Saxena, maybe you can ask if anyone is interested to, you know, come up with some comment, and then you can conclude. You can take a few questions and then.
बाय से ओपन जिनके भी मन में जो प्रश्न हो वो अपने खुले दिल से पूछ सकते हैं. हमारे पास कई ऐसे विशेषज्ञ यहाँ बैठे हुए हैं जो कि अपनी प्रतिभा के धनी हैं, लंबे समय से साधनात्मक पुरुषार्थ भी कर रहे हैं और ज्ञान के क्षेत्र में भी शिरोमणि है. सो द बोर्ड इज ओपन टू ऑल. वैष्णवी, सुजीत, अपूर्वा जी या डॉक्टर केंजल, ओपी नोडियाल साहब, जो भी बेहतर लगे आप प्रश्न ले सकते हैं.
प्रोफेसर ओपी नोटियाल जी से आप बात कर लीजिए, क्या वो कुछ कहना चाहते हैं.
सर, प्रोफेसर ओपी नोटियाल सर.
हेलो. जी सर. हेलो, एम आई ऑडिबल सर?
जी जी.
यस.
हेलो, मेरी आवाज आ रही है सर?
सर आ रही है, आप बोलिए प्लीज.
जी, first of all, being a part of organizing committee, I would like to welcome and thanks to all dignitaries,
जी,
and professors and chief guest of the today, Sri Munna Singh Chauhan sahab. खास तौर पे मैं श्री मुन्ना सिंह चौहान जी का भी धन्यवाद यहाँ पे करना चाहूंगा कि आप हर समय यूसर के साथ रहते हैं. जब भी आपको हमने आमंत्रित किया, आपने अपना आशीर्वाद और अपना वक्त हमको दिया सर. यहाँ पे बहुत सारी चीजें अभी डिस्कस हुई हैं, बहुत सारी बातें हुई हैं. निसंदेह ये जो आज यहाँ पे एक दुर्लभ संयोग है कि हमारी भारतीय संस्कृति से लेके वैदिक विज्ञान, वैदिक शास्त्र से लेके ट्रेडिशनल जो विस्डम है उनकी बात के साथ साथ आधुनिक विज्ञान और टेक्नोलॉजी, मॉडर्न साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी को जोड़ के हम बात कर रहे हैं. और उसी के आधार पे जो हमारे वेद हैं, उपनिषद हैं, क्योंकि उनमें ज्ञान और विज्ञान का अथाह भंडार है, और उनको किस प्रकार से मॉडर्न साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी से जोड़ करके जो कि हम काम कर भी रहे हैं, मानव मात्र के कल्याण के लिए किस प्रकार से कार्य किया जा सकता है, उसी के संदर्भ में जो है प्रोफेसर दुर्गेश पंत साहब और हमारे प्रोफेसर अभय सक्सेना साहब जो कि देव संस्कृति यूनिवर्सिटी में कार्यरत हैं और आप हमारे इंटरनेशनल जो साइंस आउटरीच प्रोग्राम है यूसर का उसके कोऑर्डिनेटर भी हैं, और आप हमारे वैदिक इंफॉर्मेटिक जो सेंटर यूसर के द्वारा आप ही के यहाँ पे स्थापित किया गया है उसके भी कोऑर्डिनेटर हैं. तो आप लोगों के द्वारा ये जो है सेंटर स्थापित किया गया है और बहुत सारी इसमें अब एक्टिविटीज आगे रन होने के आसार हैं. ये बहुत बड़ा संयोग है कि हमारे आज पॉलिसी मेकर हमारे मुन्ना सिंह चौहान साहब, आदरणीय माननीय विधायक जी हमारे साथ हैं, साइंटिस्ट एंड एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर एंड एकेडमिशियन एंड आईआईटी प्रोफेसर्स, आईआईटी प्रोफेसर्स सारे लोग यहाँ पे उपस्थित हैं. तो बहुत सारी चीजें यहाँ निकल के आई हैं, जैसे यूसर्क के द्वारा विभिन्न संस्थाओं में कई प्रकार के सेंटर बनाए गए हैं, जैसे सेंटर ऑफ साइंस आउटरीच जो गंगोली हाट पिथौरागढ़ में है, ऐसे ही उत्तराखंड साइंस फॉर सेंटर फॉर क्लाइमेट चेंज जो कुमाऊं यूनिवर्सिटी में है, सेंटर ऑफ एक्सेलेंस इन मैथमेटिकल साइंस अल्मोड़ा में, टेक्नोलॉजी एनेबल्ड एजुकेशन का एक सेंटर HNB गढ़वाल यूनिवर्सिटी श्रीनगर, इसी प्रकार से जो हमारा वैदिक इन्फॉर्मेटिक साइंस का यहाँ पे देव संस्कृत विश्वविद्यालय में ये जो है सेंटर बनाया गया है उसी के तहत जो आज प्रोग्राम है. तो मुझे लगता है कि बहुत सारी चीजें इसमें आउटकम के रूप में हमको मिली हैं. उस बेस पे जो हमारे अंतर्राष्ट्रीय राष्ट्रीय स्तर के जितने भी हमारे आज के इस वेबिनार में जुड़े हुए हैं प्रोफेसर और जितने भी हमारे बुद्धिजीवी लोग रहे, आप लोगों का जो भी यहाँ पे थॉट आया वो हमारे लिए काफी मार्गदर्शक का काम करेगा, और हम इसी बेस पे जो यहाँ पे चीजें निकल के आई, चाहे वो जो है किस प्रकार से इसको वेद और वैदिक साइंस और वेद उपनिषदों के जो ज्ञान के भंडार की बात है, किस प्रकार से मॉडर्न साइंस के तहत हम उसको जो है प्लेटफॉर्म पे ला सकते हैं, प्रयास करेंगे इस सेंटर के तहत उस कार्य को आगे बढ़ाया जा सके. मैं यहाँ पे सभी का धन्यवाद करना चाहूंगा कि आप सभी यहाँ पे इस वेबिनार में आए, खासतौर पर प्रोफेसर अभय सक्सेना साहब जिन्होंने ये बहुत जबरदस्त प्रोग्राम यहाँ पे स्टार्ट किया है. यूं तो यूसर्क द्वारा आजकल जो ये COVID-19 के दौरान जो हमारा आजकल का जो ये प्रोग्राम चल रहा है, जब सारे लोग ये लॉकडाउन की स्थिति है, तो विभिन्न हमारे ई वर्कशॉप तो चल ही रहे हैं, चाहे वो डेटा साइंस की हो, साइबर सिक्योरिटी की हो, या फिर जो है कि किसी वेब सेमिनार की हो कोविड-19 से लेके, और जो है अभी कल हमारा जो है उसमें वाटर टेक्नोलॉजी पे होने वाला है, साइंस ऑफ सर्वाइवल पे होने वाला है, टेक्नोलॉजी एनेबल्ड एजुकेशन पे होने वाला है, स्मार्ट इको क्लब पे जो है एक प्रोग्राम होने वाला है। तो इस प्रकार से जो ये हमारे वेबिनार के सेंस में चलते जा रहे हैं, लेकिन फिर भी खासतौर पर आज का जो प्रोग्राम रहा काफी संक्षिप्त रहा, मैं इसके लिए अभय सक्सेना साहब को बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद कहना चाहूंगा। और आपके द्वारा आगे जो भी इसमें प्रोग्राम बनाया जाएगा, हम पूरा प्रयास करेंगे कि आपके साथ मिल करके इसको हम एक आगे एक इस सोपान पे ऐसे पहुंचाएं कि उसका कुछ जो है ट्रुथफुल सभी को लगे कि इसमें कुछ न कुछ आउटपुट आया है। थैंक यू।
अमित पंडित साहब, आप कुछ बोलना चाहेंगे? डॉक्टर अमित,
नमस्कार सर। सभी उपस्थित माननीयों को मेरा नमस्कार। मैं अमितकांत पंडित माता वैष्णो देवी यूनिवर्सिटी कटरा से बोल रहा हूँ। आप सभी विद्वानों के बीच बैठ के मैं सवा घंटा सुनता ही रहा और बड़ा अच्छा लगा सुन के कि हम लोग किस किस एरिया में काम कर रहे हैं और कितना काम करना अभी बाकी है। प्रोफेसर अभय के यूनिवर्सिटी में जो ये सेंटर बना है, ये सेंटर एक बहुत ही मील का पत्थर साबित होगा इस एरिया में शिक्षक के शिक्षण के लिए। मैं आशा करता हूँ कि मुझे आप आगे ऐसे जोड़ते रहेंगे और मेरा भी ज्ञान इससे बढ़ता रहेगा। धन्यवाद। जय माता दी।
अमित जी, आप हमेशा जुड़े हुए हैं।
जी, आप धन्यवाद जी।
विभा कश्यप जी, आप कुछ पूछना चाहेंगी?
सर, मेरे हिसाब से तो मेरे पास अभी के लिए तो कोई क्वेश्चन नहीं है, लेकिन फ्यूचर में मेरे हिसाब से मैं बहुत ज्यादा सवाल लेकर आपके पास आने वाली हूँ। थैंक यू सो मच सच्ची, सीरियसली इट्स अ वेरी वेरी गुड थिंग, लेकिन मुझे बहुत नॉलेज की जरूरत है अभी। इतनी ज्यादा इनसाइट्स और ग्लिम्पस मुझे मिल गए हैं कि मैंने अभी 3 points लिख लिए हैं जो आगे एज अ कंपनी, एज एन इंडिविजुअल और आगे मैं कुछ एजुकेशन के फील्ड में जो करना चाहूंगी, मैं ऑफ कोर्स इन्हें कंसीडर करूंगी। और थैंक यू सो मच, मुझे नहीं लगता कि ऐसा वर्कशॉप मैंने पहले किया है। यस, जब यूनिवर्सिटी में थी तब ऐसा कुछ तो हुआ था, लेकिन उससे काफी अलग और बहुत कुछ अच्छा मुझे जो है सीखने के लिए मिला। थैंक यू सो मच अभय सक्सेना सर और आप सभी का। थैंक यू।
स्वस्ति कृष्णा, यू वांट टू ऐड अप समथिंग? स्वस्ति कृष्णा,
तो प्रोफेसर एमपी थपलियाल, प्रोफेसर एमपी थपलियाल हैं गढ़वाल यूनिवर्सिटी से। हेलो, सक्सेना सर आप कंक्लूड कर दीजिए मेरी समस्या।
तो सभी ठीक है सर, जैसा आपका आदेश हो। सबसे पहले तो
आप पूछ लीजिए, आप पूछ लीजिए, अगर किसी ने कुछ कहना है जोड़ना है, और जो इसके मिनट्स हैं हम इसके मिनट्स भी सर्कुलेट कर देंगे, और किसी ने मेल भेज के अपनी कई चीजें हम इसमें जोड़ सकते हैं आगे को, और ये एक बहुत ही बहुत एक अपने आप में ना।
डॉक्टर दुर्गे,
यस सर,
वेरी स्मॉल सजेशन, ऑल्दो माय डॉक्टर स्वप्निल हैज क्लियर्ड माय डाउट टू सम एक्सटेंट, दैट वैदिक स्टडी, वैदिक नॉलेज एंड द मॉडर्न डे द वेस्टर्न साइंस दैट यू कॉल इट आर टू डिफरेंट स्ट्रीम्स एंड देयर इज नो नीड टू मिक्स द टू। But if I say, because you said that COVID-19 has taught us a lesson that by making good use of the digital knowledge and online services and transfer of information, so and so forth, so we can make the lives of the people better off and save the humanity of the onslaught of so many things at times. But especially my request to Professor Abhay Saxena, because it's a wonderful institution of its kind in the world, rather I'll call it.
Yes.
Will it be possible to have a proper structured study of some elements of Vedic science, so that we can we can with finality, conformity, or with authority. This is just scientifically proven, although as per the Swapnil's scientifically proven subject expression, but is it possible to initiate some structured studies of the scientific aspect of Vedic knowledge?
तो जैसा कि आपने हमसे अपेक्षित किया है हम कोशिश कर रहे हैं और एक मैं अपनी बुक भी आपको दूंगा सर वैदिक इंफॉर्मेटिक पे ही है ये भी हाल में ही
अच्छा मैं भी अभी भाई मैं भी यही दिखाने वाला था वैदिक इंफॉर्मेटिक्स पे आपकी पुस्तक मैं भी दिखाने वाला था चौहान साहब को कि ये फ्रूशन है ये मैं आपको दूंगा और आपको अच्छा लगेगा कि हम सही दिशा में आगे बढ़ रहे हैं
I apologize for my missing Vedic knowledge and Vedic science.
The ज्ञान सीमित है सर असीमित है ना हमें संजय सक्सेना जी ने समझाया उमा शंकर पांडे ने समझाया आपने समझाया प्रोफेसर पन्न ने समझाया हम सब जिंदगी भर सीख ही तो रहे हैं सर आंखें खुली हो तो पूरी जिंदगी विश्वविद्यालय है सर मैंने तो इतना ही सीखा है कि जिंदगी में सीखना हमेशा जारी रखना चाहिए तो इन्हीं खूबसूरत मोड़ पर सर इस मीटिंग को यहाँ रोकते हैं सभी माननीय विद्वानों को हम दिल से धन्यवाद करते हैं यू सर का धन्यवाद करते हैं प्रोफेसर पंत का माननीय विधायक महोदय का और कभी मिलने का मौका मिला सर तो हम आपको मिलने देहरादून जरूर आएंगे शांति पाठ से सर समाप्ति करेंगे मैं डॉक्टर शिवनारायण जी से निवेदन करूंगा मंत्रों से हम सबको इस पूर्ण मंत्र में जरा शांति प्रदान करें
आइए हम लोग जहां भी बैठे हैं सांचित अपने आप को शांति की भावनाओं करते हुए शांति की याचना करेंगे क्षिति जल पावक गगन समीरा हर जगह शांति व्याप्त हो ऐसे वातावरण में इस समय के वातावरण में शांति की प्रभु त्रिभुवन शांति जल में थल और गगन शांति अंतरिक्ष में अग्नि पवन में शांति औषधि वनस्पति वन पुवन में शांति की सकल विश्व के जड़ चेतन शांति की शांति विश्व निर्माण सृजन में शांति नगर ग्राम में और भवन में शांति मिले जीव मात्र के तन में मन शांति और जगत के हर कण कण में शांति
प्रभु त्रिभुवन शांति कीजिए शांति कीजिए शांति कीजिए शांति कीजिए शांति 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 शांति
आप सभी को बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद सर धन्यवाद फिर बहुत बहुत आप सभी का और हम लोग फिर इसी तरह से मिलते रहेंगे थैंक यू वेरी मच प्रोफेसर पंत सर
थैंक यू सर